Yes. Welcome back, children. In the last class, we have studied the author, the narrator, sorry. He enters black aeroplane. He takes risk and he sees that everything is black. But suddenly, he sees another aeroplane and another pilot who is also stuck in this black aeroplane, and he waves his hand and offers help to the narrator. Now, you see what happens. That is on page number 38, last paragraph. He turned his aeroplane slowly to the north in front of my Dakota so that it would be easier for me to follow him. I was very happy to go behind the strange aeroplane like an obedient child. After half an hour, the strange black aeroplane was still there in front of me in the clouds. So, what does the other pilot do? He comes in front of the narrator's aeroplane and he shows the way to the narrator. Now the narrator is happy. He follows the other pilot. So they fly for half an hour. See, you know what happens afterwards? Now there was only enough fuel in the old Dakota's last tank to fly for 5 to 10 minutes. Now the narrator was running out of fuel. The fuel to fly for only 5 to 10 minutes was remaining. I was starting to feel frightened. Again he was frightened because the fuel was getting exhausted. But then he started to go down and I followed through the storm. So the other pilot, he moves down towards the ground. So the writer also follows him. Suddenly I came out of the clouds and saw two long straight lines of light in front of me. It was a runaway. An airport, I was safe. So what when now the narrator has come out of this black aeroplane, and what does he see? He sees that the aeroplane was landing on a runaway. That is, he has arrived at the aeroplane. Now he had a sigh of relief that he was safe. I turned to look for my friend in the black aeroplane, but the sky was empty. There was nothing there. The black aeroplane was gone. I could not see it anyway. Now the narrator wanted to thank the other pilot, so he turns back to see the other aeroplane, but to his amazement, there was no other aeroplane, nor the pilot. I landed and was not sorry to walk away from the old Dakota near the control tower. Why does the author say that he was not sorry to walk away? See, because actually he should feel sorry because he was not able to thank the other pilot. But he says that he was not feeling sorry. He was not feeling sorry because he was content that he landed safely on the ground. This gave him more happiness than thanking the other pilot. I went and asked a woman in the control center where I was and who the other pilot was. I wanted to say thank you. So the narrator, he goes to the control room and he asked the lady, that woman sitting in the office, who is the other pilot and which aeroplane was there with me. Then, and he says that I just wanted to thank the other pilot. At that, you know what she says? She looks at me very strangely and then laughs. Another aeroplane up there in this storm? No other aeroplane was flying tonight. Yours was the only one I could see on the radar. Now, the woman at the radio counter informs the narrator that no, tonight, that is, the previous night, only your aeroplane was flying in the sky. In the storm, there was no other aeroplane in the sky. So who helped me to arrive there safely without a compass or a radio and without any more fuel in my tank? Who was the pilot on the strange black aeroplane flying in the storm without flights? Now you see, children, this story has ended. This story has a mysterious ending. So there's no clear ending given. So now the narrator, he is confused, he is perplexed, and he wants to know who was the man in the other aeroplane, where has the aeroplane vanished. So let's come to an ending. So what do you think, children? Well, I think probably there was no real other person, or you can say no other aeroplane was flying, but it was only his pilot's own self that helped him through the storm. So children, have you heard of hallucination? So what is the situation of hallucination? So hallucination is a situation where we hear some odd noise, some odd sound, and we feel that someone is there in the dark room, someone is besides us. But in reality, there's nothing like that. It is only a type of feeling. Same way, this writer, this narrator, he also experienced this feeling. Actually, there was no other pilot or no other aeroplane who helped him, but it was his own self. So, what the writer of this chapter wants to give us the message that we should never lose hope. So, we should always be ready to take risk and we should always be ready to help ourselves. As we have seen, when we have seen this narrator, he took the risk of entering the black aeroplane. So, he enters. The black cloud. When he enters the black cloud, he is confused. Now, he sees everything that there was darkness. So, he wanted to come out of this black cloud. So, he only imagines that there is someone, other pilot who is helping him. But on his own, he helps himself. He takes risk and he doesn't lose hope. And he is successful in landing to the ground. So, children, that is the end of this lesson. So, both these lessons, I'll be giving you some questions of worksheets. And please do them in your class copies. And children, don't take them easy. You have to study religiously. Please follow the guidelines. Please listen to all the videos which are uploaded. Because as such, yours is 10th board class and you're running out of time. So, you need to be on your heels. Study them. Try to find the answers. Do the homeworks assigned by the teachers religiously in your class copy. Okay, children. So, that's all for today. And please do the question answers of both the lessons. Part A, Part B of third chapter in your copy. So, children, till now, we have finished 5 lessons. Okay. 2, 3 we have done from this first flight. And 2 poems we have completed from this book. And the other book also, I guess we have done 1 or 2 chapters. I'm not getting. Wait just a second. Let me see and tell you. From Footprints Without Feet, we have finished 1 chapter. That is A Triumph of Surgery. I had already given you question answers of that chapter. So, please do them in your copy. Okay, children. Bye.